today I'm going to be doing a tutorial on how to use xpadder and set it up for your Xbox 360 controller. It works the same way for other controllers, so if you want to do that, just follow the on-screen instructions, as you see. Okay, so you've got, so I'll put a link in the description. So yeah, you should get this WinRAR or 7-zip file. Open it with WinRAR or 7-zip, and then just, if you want, you can extract the file, but I'm not going to. And then, yeah, so you're going to want to open it with WinRAR or 7-zip. Once you open it up, you're going to find this file called xpadder.exe or .jar, depending. And just double click that, and it should come up with this little message here. Now, basically what you want to do, you just want to click start, then it'll say where you'd like to save the files you're going to be creating. So I'm going to click program location because it's probably the easiest, and I think you should do too. Sorry, my voice is so bad today. Anyway, you should do that, and then you're going to click associate if you're on Windows. If you're not on Windows, then just click do not associate. And then you should get something like this. If you don't, then you probably haven't plugged your controller into your Xbox using your USB connection or whatever you're going to plug it in with. Anyway, so you're going to click this little controller icon here. Then you're going to click new, and you're going to get this little box here. So I've got a Mad Cat's Call of Duty game pad thing. It's just an Xbox controller, but Call of Duty version. And then you're going to want to go to, so you'll say start, create controller layout, and the link for this picture will also be in the description, or you can just get it off Google Images. Actually, I won't put it on the description, just type in xpadder Xbox 360 controller, and then it'll come up with this picture. So yeah, you just want to open this picture that you just saved. Mine is somewhere here, inside the documents or something. God, just give me a second. I'm really sorry about this. I cannot find it for some reason. Be in my pictures. There it is. Sorry. There you go. That's there. So it should come up on there as well. So yeah, once you've got this picture up, you're gonna want to go to sticks and click stick one enabled. So it'll come up with this little message here. Just grab your Xbox 360 controller and follow the on-screen instructions. It said pull stick one left, so you can do that. And this is, by the way, the left stick. And then you're going to want to pull it up, as it says, and then do that, and then get your mouse and just drag it where the controller is, like that. Okay, now you're going to go to stick 2, which is the right stick, sorry, go to enabled, and do the same thing, but for the right stick. Okay, drag that across there. Okay, that should be like that. And then just ignore that direction names if you're on the Xbox. Thank you. Then you're going to want to go to D-pad. Go to D-pad enabled, and then follow the instructions again. Up, down, left, right, like so. And then just drag it over to your D-pad, like so. Okay, then that's fine. Then buttons. Now, this one, all you have to do is, if you want to add a button, just click the button on your Xbox controller. So I'm going to click A, and it pops up there. Just drag it over to A, like so. Then B, click it, drag it over to B. X, again, and do it for all your buttons. drag it over to the picture. So I'm just going to do that now. So that's the start button I just clicked. I don't think you'll need to click the middle button. I don't think you're going to need that. So, well, I'm not. At least, that's the left bumper. That's the right bumper. I think that's everything. So, yeah. And you go into triggers, and then click analog triggers enabled. Now, it'll give you this little message. Now, it says hold left trigger, so you're going to hold that down. Now hold right trigger, so you can hold that one down, and then like so, and then you're done for this little part. Click finish, click close, and then it's coming up with this now, so as you can see, I'm moving my things now. Okay, so you click on each one, so I'm just going to click on this little tool thing, speed it up. Now, so, because this is based on Minecraft for me, you're just going to want to click on WSAD, so if you're doing it for COD, I'm not sure what the controls are, but I'm assuming it's WASD, like on Minecraft. Do the same thing for this, so this will be look around, so it'll be mouse normal for me. So D-pad, I'm just gonna, oh yeah, you know what to do. A, I'm gonna do space for jump. B, I'm gonna do right click, which is that one. X is gonna be that one. Y can be, just do it for whatever you want. I'm just messing around here really. Y can be inventory. Start. Just do whatever you want. I'm just gonna just do random things like fly mod on, drop, F5. You know, just do whatever you want. This can be fly up and down. That, oh god, I've done that wrong. Sorry. That one can be Top of Fog, that's for G. That can be Fly Down. This one, whatever you want, just do it for whatever game you're doing it. So, as you would play it on your, as you play it with your mouse and your keyboard, you're just basically setting it up so it knows what your, what it's meant to be detecting. So, I'll put that one. That and then just click X. So now you've done all that, you've got all them set up. What you want to do, you click. I don't think you need to save, but you can save it just in case something goes wrong. I'm not going to save it on this one. And then you just click X. And so if you try and control your mouse now with your right stick, it should work. See, I'm doing it now, like so. So you can exit off that now, so all of your keys are set up. So let's just test this by going into Minecraft, or whatever game you're going to do, you can test it in. Sorry about the lag, it's because I'm recording, so this will be quite bad. So I'm just going to go multiplayer, just connect to a server. Sorry about this lag, but this is me. So I am controlling it with my Xbox controller right now. So that's like click there and right click there. So I will don't forget to comment, rate and subscribe. Thank you for watching this video. I hope it helped. And if you want more videos like tutorials on games like Minecraft or Call of Duty. I won't be able to do Call of Duty games till Christmas because that's when I'm getting my gaming computer. So yeah, I hope this helped. This video helped you, and good luck in future things.